Hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Welcome into the presence of the Lord here at God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries. Apostolic Power, the place of established love and care for the nations. Yes, truly, Apostle Dr. Hinkson, the mother apostle of the nations, coming to you live on this fourth day of April 2024 from the upper room. Here at our headquarters, 31022 Southeast, Cleveland, Tennessee, 37311. When I bless you in every nation, tribe, and tongue, in Jesus' name, welcome, welcome, welcome. Hallelujah, glory to God, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. I'm going to be sending some invites as we just honor the Lord. The time is come, and now is when true worshipers who worship the Father in spirit and truth, because he's seeking such to worship him. Welcome into the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Welcome, everyone. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're my God. God bless you. Hallelujah. 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 You're my God. God bless you. Welcome, welcome. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're my God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You're my God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You're my God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're my God. God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, 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 you're my God. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, God bless you. Welcome into the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord, you're my God. I bless you, I bless you, the city, I bless you, the country. I bless you when you come and when you go, the head and above the tear, above and up beneath. God bless you, welcome into the house of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Please share the page as we lift up the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the company of the tribe of Judah that breaks every chain. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah, hallelujah, you're my God. Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, hallelujah, glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, you're my God. Hallelujah, you are my God. Hallelujah, welcome to this brief moment, hallelujah, of our Christian education, evangelism, and discipleship empowerment time on this beautiful Thursday. Glory to God, of 2024, April 4th. Glory to God. I'm super excited, amen, just to come on to share with you what we are doing, where we are, and what we are about to see God do. Glory to God, exceedingly abundantly above all we could ask or think, according to his power that is at work within me, within you. Glory to God. Amen. As the scripture says in Psalm 100, make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he who have made us and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. We enter into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting. And his truth endures to all generations. Glory to God. And God is so beautifully assigned me. Glory to God, to look at the various generations, glory to God, irrespective of where you are in the world, from North America to South America to Africa to Asia to Europe to Australia, Oceania, Antarctica, all seven continents and houses the nations of the world. Glory to God. It is said currently that 193 nations and states are recognized by the UN. And of course, you have other territories as well. Glory to God. And so all 200 plus nations and territories, amen, we are here to honor the Lord. As Psalm 24 says, amen, the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof, the world and they that dwell therein. For he is founded upon the seas and established upon the floods. He said, who shall ascend into the hill of the Lord, or who shall stand in his holy place? He that hath clean hands and pure hearts, for the little of your souls to vanity are sworn deceitfully. So he shall receive a blessing from the Lord and righteousness from the God of his salvation. So this is the generation of them that seek me, that seek thy face, O God of Jacob. Lift up your heads, O ye gates, and be lifted up everlasting doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord strong and mighty, the Lord mighty in battle. So lift up your heads, O gates, and be lifted up everlasting doors, that the King of glory may come in. Who is this King of glory? The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory. And so I salute you today. Glory to God. I honor God for each and every one of you. Amen. Glory to God, male and female, Jew and Gentile, bond or free. Glory to God, all the apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers, bishops, elders, brothers, sisters, ministers, and people, believers and seekers in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I honor God for each and every one of you today around the world. Glory to God. To God be all the glory. The Bible said many are called, but few are chosen. And thank God I'm among the chosen. Glory to God. Highly favored to be able to carry forth the cross of Jesus Christ in the spirit of excellence. Glory to God as I serve. Amen. My family. Amen. And the community. Amen. Praying for communities impacting nations for the kingdom of God. I want to give special honor, amen, to my immediate family the Lord has blessed me with. Amen. My husband, Mr. Frank G. Hinkson, glory to God, and also our three children that God has so blessed us with. Amen. Alana, Isaiah, and Micah Hinkson, glory to God. Thank God they are great kingdom ambassadors for the Lord. And I will always say, as for me and my house, we will serve the Lord. Glory to God. And so thank God for each of you, part of the family of God. I bless God for you. I honor the Lord for you. Glory to God. I've been working so hard to get to this place to make sure the establishment of the work of God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries, Apostolic Hub, the place of established love and care for the nations, is a place at all times whereby which, amen, we can serve Jesus Christ and to know that he shows no favoritism, but wherever you're calling upon the name of the Lord from any nation, irrespective of your socioeconomic background, glory to God, irrespective of what you go through in your life, amen, we know that Jesus Christ is the way, the truth, and the life, and no one comes to the Father except through him. Glory to God. So as you know, I've mentioned on Mondays and Thursdays, amen, I try to do our Christian education, evangelism, and discipleship empowerment time, which is a great catalyst for God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries and the University of Bible College and Theological Seminary that we do have, amen, and allowing leaders to get introduced, amen, to the educational certification process that we do offer, glory to God, through the Empower School of Discipleship Masterclass. And you can always go to our website, amen, GLTIMApostolicHub.org. I've also posted the link there that you're able to click on that to be able to also see what we do offer here as far as the Empower School of Discipleship Masterclass and Gateway Certification Program to help leaders locally, nationally, internationally to be fully acquainted with the laws, the biblical worldview of Jesus Christ. Amen. The way, the truth, and the life. So I just came on today briefly to give you an overview and to at least invite all of you to join with me. I will say boldly, as 1 Corinthians 11:1 says, follow me as I follow Christ. Amen. Glory to God. Today, I had the great honor to attend a court session today at the locally here, and regarding looking at my family and structure. And what was so beautiful today was a few words that were used. One specifically in that I really commended the representative in using is making sure that this particular establishment of the local court here that actually sees about family, glory to God, it's not an adversarial it's not an adversarial connection, but rather as we're serving our communities, glory to God, certainly we can see a great construct of what God is doing. So in the family mountain, the religion mountain, education, business, government, arts, entertainment, media mountain, as mother apostle to the nations, it's incumbent upon me to be an example in word, in conversation, charity, purity. And so it was great as the judge was asking if I would like to represent myself or would have an attorney to represent me. Certainly, I chose to represent myself, much like the Apostle Paul in Acts chapter 26, when he had to stand before the court, and he asked them to be quite patient with him as he gave his testimonial. And I always love to use the apostles, amen, that Jesus chose actually to be able to demonstrate the way in which I live my life according to the leading of Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. He's the great example. He's the chief apostle of our souls. Glory to God. And so, amen, as you continue to speak in and through me, I want to make sure each of you as well learn as Christian believers, amen, to let our light so shine before mankind that they can see our good work and be led to glorify our Father, which is in heaven. And so I want to be able to spend the time briefly just to greet you all. Amen. Today, also officially, I'll be starting to do some substitute teaching in the public schools here in Cleveland, Tennessee. I'm getting more acclimated to the various sectors. Amen. I've been here in Cleveland, Tennessee for the last 20 years, and over the last decade, God has allowed me to fully establish and birth forth God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries here in the realm of the earth. And so, glory to God, always want to make sure that when I go out and come in, and when all of you around the world, all the nations of the world, when you do come to Cleveland, Tennessee, you'll receive a warm welcome, one with great understanding, because we know what the scripture says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoso believes in him should not perish but have everlasting life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but the world through him may be saved. So I want to pray with you, and just to glory to God, just to give you an overview of what I'll be doing, amen, as I'm moving forward, amen, in a timely manner. Glory to God. Time is everything, and Jesus, amen, spent his time to make sure
that things were intact. So when he ascended back to heaven, glory to God, as we just celebrated Resurrection Sunday, amen. Certainly, glory to God for all of us in the world that are serving Jesus Christ and certainly want to be a doorway, amen, glory to God, to lead others to Christ. We want to make sure that we are understanding our assignment. Amen. I ministered a message recently that says judgment must begin at the house of God. And if the righteous scarcely make it, let's say the ungodly, according to 1 Peter chapter 4, verse 17. So I want to bless God for each and every one of you today. Glory to God. And thank God for each of you and your nation. As the Bible says, we should pray. Glory to God. 2 Timothy chapter 2. Amen. The Apostle Paul, who was actually mentoring Timothy, gave him the construct that was necessary. Amen. To pray for those in authority that we can live a peaceable and quiet life. Glory to God. And so it's important, as Paul also affirmed Timothy, that he saw, amen, the life of faith that he was living. He saw it in his Timothy's grandmother, his mother, and had no doubt the same faith is also in him. And so it's wonderful for me personally that all of you, as you've known me as a mother apostle to the nations, certainly I'm a mother myself to three beautiful children, amen, a wife to one husband. Glory to God, Mr. Hinkson. I want to always make sure that I commit you, amen, around the world to one husband, which is to Christ Jesus. Amen. Glory to God, as the bride of Christ. So I want to bless you today in Jesus' name. Please share the page. Let me know that you've shared the page. Glory to God. And also, amen, glory to God. I would love for you to hear what nation you're logging on from. Amen. As I pray, amen, and intercede, amen, to the Lord. I want to also honor the Lord. Amen for my father. Amen. Glory to God. Bishop Michael Williams, who's also my, amen, my birth and my spiritual father. Honor the Lord for him and certainly my family, my extended family, and also my in-laws. Amen. Glory to God. Thank God for the opportunity. Thank God for the different groups of leaders that I've put around me, whether it's through my board of directors. Amen. Glory to God. And my accountability board. Amen. People and support systems that I've put in place that actually helps me to regulate my life. So I know that we all, amen, have to give an account to the Lord for what we do. Amen. As we serve, and we are not an island to ourselves. Amen. I love the mantra. Let's say no one is an island. No one stands alone. Each one needs his brother. Each one needs his friend. So building community at all times is of paramount, amen, importance to me. And I hope it is to you as well. Praise God. I would love to really invite all of you around the world to please take some time to visit. My website, the website for God's Lighthouse. Also read the mission and vision. Get to read a little bit about my story as well, because I think that will also help us to learn proper ways in which we do things. I've also spent the time to post on my Facebook feed, amen, a way in which to measure how I appropriate my life in the sense of reaching out to me, how you can contact me, glory to God. And certainly I want to highlight that for you to make sure that you are following suit. Amen. That's a great way to reach me. There is the email address, GLTIMApostolicHub@gmail.com, our website, GLTIMApostolicHub.org, and our headquarters where it's located. Also, if you're going to reach out to me and you'd like for me to receive your information, you can always go ahead and send a text to 423-740-2992. Glory to God. And so for those of you in our WhatsApp group, you can also reach me at 423-584-0604. Glory to God. I'll certainly receive the message either way, whether you either the 423-740-2992. And if you certainly want to come and be a part, it's certainly important for you to recognize the way in which we're able to communicate effectively and productively. Amen. Praise God. So to God be all the glory for the great things he has done and he continues to do. Amen. As we seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, He says, everything else shall be added. Amen. Praise God. So please just follow suit for me. Amen. Shall we go to the Lord in prayer? Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, I come to you in the name of Jesus Christ, by the blood of the Lamb, by the word of my testimony. Glory to God. I thank you for this opportunity to have settled in, Lord God, to this calling that you've called me to, a heavenly calling, and I've not been disobedient to the heavenly vision. And I thank you, Father, that as you shine your light through me, as you've asked me to do that, Lord God, ever so graciously, you've nudged me to stand in the middle, allow you to shine your light in and through me. I pray, Abba Father, that right now that you'll allow your presence to flood the airwaves. Glory to God, as my voice go out, to be a voice in the wilderness, preparing the way of the Lord. Thank you, Father God, for my life, my family, my husband, my children, Lord God, my extended family, Lord God, and in-laws, and above and beyond. Thank you for the family of God around the world. We are connected by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. And so, Father, I ask that this moment and this time, as we begin to share the word briefly, I ask you, dear God, for divine grace and wisdom and power and knowledge in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. So I want to be able to at least let you know, this is just an overview moving forward. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. I pride myself in three things specifically. I love people. Amen. So all of you, you're loved by the Lord. That's why God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries is the place of established love and care for the nations. The second thing you know about me is I love to communicate. Communication is not just only speaking, but communication is demonstration. The Bible says everywhere Jesus went, he was doing good. And our doing becomes a part of our being, which is our character. And the third thing you'll know about me is I love to travel. Amen. And to travel is not just only traveling, taking a plane or a bus or a car or so forth or ship. Amen. But you travel through prayer and fasting and the word, and you travel by building bridges. Amen. To demonstrate what you're doing and identifying with humanity as Jesus did. Amen. Glory to God. To all, let us know that we're human. Amen. Christ was wounded for transgressions. He was bruised for iniquity. But the chastening of our peace was upon him, and by his stripes you were healed. So what does that mean? It means that, the songs, we all bleed the same. So the Bible said, do unto others as you love to be done to yourself. The Bible said, love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love your neighbor as yourself. So I want to make sure at all times that I'm demonstrating that. Glory to God. Amen. To God be all the glory. Glory to God. Amen. As I'm in the community, one of the things that I was able to share before the judge today, along with several witnesses with regards to my life and family, is to know that I love to be proactive in what I do. I don't do reactions. I act in my proactiveness. And so I speak intelligently. I speak also from a place of strength, knowing who I am and what I represent and who I represent. And so I want to make sure I model to mentor. As you all know that this month of April, we're focusing on discipleship. I have actually mentioned the fact that we're doing for 2024, we're doing the core Kingdom of Heaven relationships. That's the acronym for core Kingdom of Heaven relationships, and focusing on the 12 different ships. January, I focused on leadership. February, I focused on fellowship. March, I focused on membership. So this month, April, we focus on discipleship. And then May, we're focusing on worship. June, we focus on partnership. And then July, we focus on sponsorship. And August, we focus on friendship. And September, we focus on apostleship. And October, we focus on scholarship. And November, we focus on companionship. And December, we focus on stewardship. Amen. And so I would definitely be highlighting those moments. Amen. I've shared extensively about my family, my three children, Alana, Isaiah, and Micah. Currently, they are the ones on staff with me here. My husband and I, the two of us are one, but these are the leaders. We took that picture on Resurrection Sunday. So this is my staff, and we're working hard to make sure we create a healthy bench of leaders that are able to walk along with me. Glory to God. Amen. So you're going to be hearing a lot more glory to God as we walk through the process. So I just wanted to come on briefly to at least give you an outline. Amen. Glory to God. You can follow me as I follow Christ. And by the end of this month of April, which happens to be my husband's birthday, I'm going to be definitely spending a lot of time to do some outlining with you, glory to God, of what is expected as I'm building the apostolic hub and certainly replicating the process for God's lighthouse to be established in every nation of the world. And my target goal is to have the opportunity to do Genesis 1:28, to be fruitful, multiply, replenish, subdue, and have dominion. I want to see that God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries as an apostolic hub is actually represented in every nation by August of 2026. And so I have to be able to make sure that I'm doing some tight reins on what is expected, is outlined already. Now I need to execute the process efficiently and effectively, finding great leaders such as yourself. You know who you are around the world within the seven mountains of influence that we're able to walk through the process appropriately and properly. Amen. And so I'm going to invite you all to tag into the scriptures. I'm going to be reading this book more intensely. It's called Invading the Seven Mountains of Intercession, How to Reclaim Society Through Prayer by Tommy Finwright. And this is actually in alliance with the construct of the Empowered School of Discipleship Masterclass. So this third semester that we're in, that started from February 1st to April 30th, actually allows us to talk about the seven mountains of influence, and which is family mountain, religion, education, business, government, arts, and media mountain, how to be true disciples of Christ. And so we also will be talking about cross-cultural experience. How do we communicate with other nations and finding the construct within all seven mountains of influence? So these are the sort of things that we're going to be sharing about. In my closing, because I need to prepare for an appointment that I must arrive at shortly, I want to do the scriptures that I did today. I was sitting down while I was waiting in the court. I got my journal. It's called Godliness Guards the Path of the Blameless. Proverbs 13, verse 6. And I did a journal and I wrote out my name and information. And I wrote out, Psalm 1. 1-6 and Psalm 4. So I want to read that for you. Today for my devotions this morning, I read through Psalm 145 to Psalm 150, also Proverbs chapter 4 and Matthew 26 about Jesus standing trial and how he prepared his disciples. So I want to encourage you all, go back and read those scriptures. But I'll read Psalm chapter 1, 1-6 for you, and Psalm chapter 4, and I'll be closing, and we'll certainly meet up back later so we're able to continue this process of our Christian education, evangelism, and discipleship empowerment. So Psalm 1, 1-6 says, the way of the righteous and the end of the ungodly. He says, blessed is the man who walks not in the counsel of the ungodly, nor stands in the path of sinners, nor sits in the seat of the scornful, but his delight is in the law of the Lord, and in his law he meditates day and night. He shall be like a tree planted by the rivers of water that brings forth its fruit in its season. Those whose leaf also shall not wither, and whatever he does shall prosper. The ungodly are not so, but are like the chaff which the wind drives away. Therefore, the ungodly shall not stand in the judgment, nor sinners in the congregation of the righteous. For the Lord knows the way of the righteous, but the way of the ungodly shall perish. And also in the scriptures in Psalm chapter 4, it talks about the safety of the faithful. He says, hear me when I call, O God of my righteousness. You have relieved me in my distress. Have mercy on me and hear my prayer. How long, O you sons of men, will you turn my glory to shame? How long will you love worthlessness and seek falsehood? Selah. But know that the Lord has set apart for himself him who is godly. The Lord will hear when I call to him. Be angry and do not sin. Meditate within your heart on your bed and be still. Selah. Offer the sacrifices of righteousness and put your trust in the Lord. There are many who say, who will show us any good? Lord, lift up the light of your countenance upon us. You have put gladness in my heart more than in the season that their grain and wine increased. Amen. We honor the word of God by saying glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning and now it shall be, word without end. Amen. Glory to God. Thank you all for listening. Amen. To this brief announcement and time together sharing. And I will be back. Amen. Coming to you live from the upper room here at God's Lighthouse Tabernacle International Ministries, Apostolic Hub, the place of established love and care for the nations, 310 20th Street, Southeast Cleveland, Tennessee, 37311. Yours truly, Apostle Dr. Kadene Semone, Mother, Apostle to the Nations, President, Founder, Overseer, and Visionary of this great ministry that transcends around the world. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. And may he lift up his holy counsel upon you and grant you shalom in Jesus' name. God bless you. Take care of yourself. Bye-bye. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God.